Working for starvation wages, we are going to raise the minimum wage to 15 bucks an hour. And yes, we are going to have pay equity for women. I've been all over this beautiful state of Iowa. We have spoken to some 70,000 people, and meeting after meeting, I hear people standing up and they say, Bernie, I went to college. I graduated college. Now I am $60,000, $80,000, $90,000 in debt. That is crazy. That is crazy. People should not be punished financially because they want to get a decent education. In the year 2016, public colleges and universities should be tuition free. Then my critics say, well, Bernie, that's a great idea. It's all this free stuff. How are you going to pay for it? I will tell you how we're going to pay for it. We are going to impose a tax on Wall Street. And the illegal behavior of Wall Street drove this economy to its knees. The American people bailed out Wall Street. Now it's Wall Street's time to help. Of having more people in jail than any other country. Disproportionately African American and Latino. What we are going to do is provide jobs and education for our kids, not more jails and incarceration. I'm on the Senate Energy Committee, I'm on the Senate Environmental Committee. I've talked to scientists all over the world. The debate is over. Climate change is real. And we have a moral responsibility to work with countries throughout the world to transform our energy system away from fossil fuel to energy efficiency and sustainable energy. Is that we have not one Republican candidate for president prepared to come up and tell us and agree with what virtually all scientists agree with. And you know why they are not prepared to do that? Because on the day that they do acknowledge the reality of climate change and call for change, you know what happens? They're going to lose their campaign funds to the Koch brothers. For the coal industry. Worry about the planet. You're going to be leaving your children in the grave. Now, I have been criticized during this campaign for many, many things. Every single day. That's okay. That's okay. single-payer program, which will not only guarantee health care to all, it'll not only end the pharmaceutical ripoff of the American people, but it will save the middle-class family, the average middle-class family, thousands of dollars a year in health care costs. Saying what no other candidate for president will tell you. And that is that no president, not Bernie Sanders, not anybody else, will be able to bring about the changes that the working families and the middle class of this country, that our children, that the seniors, our seniors deserve. No one president can do it, because the powers that be, Wall Street with their endless supply of money, corporate America, the large campaign donors, are so powerful that no president can do what has to be done alone.
Keep fighting!
And that is why,
what
Iowa has begun tonight is a political revolution. Given up on the political process. They're so dismayed, so frustrated with what goes on in Washington, with young people who before had never been involved in the political process.
Yeah.
And young people and working people and seniors begin to stand up and say loudly and clearly,
enough is enough!
Our government, the government of our great country, belongs to all of us, and not just a handful of billionaires. When that happens, we will transform this country. Thank you all.
Do a thing called Pete in the fucking traffic. we are going to get the fuck out of Dodge because I am not sitting around on this fucking one lane road.
Final tally?
It's not traffic in Des Moines, but we're right here at the Holiday Inn out here by the airport, which ain't exactly big in terms of the various different roads. And also the road that I'm on is definitely a one-lane road. Thank you to everybody for tuning in here. I don't know what our visibility is going to be in a second, but I watched for most of the election, and then I decided I was just going to come out here to the Bernie one. I would have stayed longer, but they won't let me use the big DSLR to shoot Bernie, and it's like, you know, other than that, it's just a bunch of people sitting around. To be honest, I love politics. I really can't handle political rallies. And I know if you're really into it, man, it's your thing. And it's not that I don't like Bernie. He seems like a very nice fellow. I don't have political rallies in my stomach. Yeah, this is the Holiday Inn by the Des Moines Airport. That's the Des Moines Airport right there. They're just they're going to load fucking Bernie's ass up and get him out to New Hampshire, where he will probably win. He has effectively, well, I mean, tomorrow, Bernie Sanders will say that they tied. He did not give credit to Hillary for winning. Hillary did not give credit to Bernie for winning. They both thanked each other in their speeches. Hillary probably came the closest to saying that they won in saying that she was breathing a big sigh of relief, which is a great way to put that. But this is not good for Bernie. Bernie needed a win here. If they could have had it all, they could have had what they wanted, Bernie would have won. Then Bernie blows Hillary out in New Hampshire, which is still probably going to happen. But ultimately, you're going to need something else for Bernie to make a run of this. Be it some kind of big unforced error. He's also got to start moderating his message. Specifically, and you saw it here today, and I know this is part of his stump speech, but the emphasis on fairness. Fairness is a great term. It's a term that Obama used a lot. It's a term that Joe Biden famously uses a lot. This is not radical democratic socialism. This is not collectivism. This isn't tax high, spend high. This is fair, right? And that plays a lot better in some of what the SEC primary states, like, you know, South Carolina, Florida, stuff like that, where he's not going to be able to lean on very, very far left voting bloc. Thank you guys again so much for hanging out. I guess we were a little bit ahead of the live news feeds there. I'm excited to get back into the car and hear some of the more breakdown. Really, the big story, aside from how close everything was Donald Trump. Oh, where am I walking? I'm walking back to my car because I want to get the fuck out before everybody else. Like, you can see, there are cars to the left and the right of me, and they are all parked up and down this one-lane road, and I want to flip my fucking car around and get the fuck out ASAP. Now, I know that I'm sure there's a ton of people running around and they're all going to drink and they're all going to, just finger bang each other in the Holiday Inn lobby. I need a GTFO. Like, I drove 15 minutes out here to catch a 5-second speech and now I'm going to get the motherfuck out. They have not called it yet. I assume this will go a little bit later into the night. The reason why candidates give their speeches, you had Hillary and Bernie give their speech now, is because of TV. They want to get on before people go to sleep. Because this ultimately, no matter what, is great free airtime for them. How you doing? Is it free? Yeah. No. They are, where's the card game plug? Well, of course, everybody, that this live stream is brought to you by The Contender, available at thecontender.us. It's why I'm here in Des Moines, and I'm able to fucking Periscope this shit here for you.